All right, this is a lesson I've had to learn on my own, which I wish I would have been taught a long time ago. But, let's face it. Some guys, like in high school and older, we're not popular with women. As we are currently, can't get a girlfriend. It's honest. We admit that to ourselves, okay? And despite what people tell us, we know it's true. But you know what? It is. However, there's only there is a lot of people don't like this because one, it requires hard work, and two, it's not what is often taught by society. But there's, as far as I can tell, only one way for guys like us to actually get a girlfriend. And it's not really like, how should I put it? It's not a fun way, it's not an easy way, and it's gonna suck, and there is no immediate reward. You're gonna feel like there's no point at times. You're gonna feel like you're gonna feel like giving up, and you can't. It's gonna take time. There's no like set time the result's gonna happen. There's nothing like that. So you're just gonna have to stick with it. And honestly, it may take 5 or 10 years out of high school for you to accomplish it. I wish I had been able to start it a long time ago. I wish someone would have taught me this a long time ago, but I really had to discover it on my own. I just had to because no one taught me this. Because it's not a popular thing to teach, it's not what people teach. The only way guys like us who are not really, well, we just don't appear attractive to women. The only way we can become attractive to women is to actually, well, work hard on ourselves. And it sucks. It really does. But we have to work on ourselves, basically address, be honest, and address the situation, the things that we know we're not attractive to women about, work on things we can work on. Let's face it, some of us really aren't attractive. So do what you can. Do what you can to help with your looks. Maybe work on facial hair. Find clothes that fit there. Find clothes that maybe bulk you up a little bit or slim you down a little bit. Maybe lose a little weight. Maybe gain a little weight because some women like guys that are a little bit bigger. Some women like guys that are real skinny. There are different body types for different women. Work on being more charismatic. Work on your finances. Work on getting better jobs. Work on reading more. Reading's a big thing. Becoming more intelligent. Knowing about different things. You have to work on yourself, and it may take 5 or 10 years out of high school in order for it to actually cause a result. And that is a long time. It's gonna be a slow process. I'm not gonna lie. And it will suck the entire time. And you can get help. You can get a support group of people who will work with you. You can join people who are working with you to attain this goal. Or you can do it on your own. You can find people who you'll vent to. Basically, you have to do this. There is like no other way. And then at the end, you'll probably get something that a number of people in society don't like, and that is a younger girl who likes an older guy. And it's just the way it is. And, that's just the kind of person we attract. The way I am now, I tend to attract younger girls, and that's just the way I am after working on myself so hard. Anyone, really, when they enter a relationship, are looking for a way to better themselves, not just women, but men too. So that's the thing. You have to make it so you would benefit someone. And you have to be honest with yourself and work hard. And it sucks. And being honest with yourself is probably one of the scariest things to do. And it's one of the scariest things I have to do for myself every day is be honest with myself, be direct with myself, call myself out. It's one of the scariest things I have to do every day. But I do it because it's what I need to do to advance. And I am advancing. You can see in my videos, I'm advancing. But you know what? It's what I have to do. It's what you're gonna have to do. It sucks. It really does. And you're gonna have good days, you're gonna have bad days, and you just push yourself every day. You don't give up. You keep throwing yourself in there, and you keep figuring out what works. It's like when David Goggins talked about how he couldn't swim, and then he figured out how to swim with his hands tied behind his back. He talked about being negative buoyant, and then he learned how to swim with his hands tied behind his back because he kept throwing himself in the water and figuring it out. That's the thing. I can show you the ways I'm working for me, but they may not work for you. If they work, cool. If they don't, if they don't, then they don't. You find what works for you. And, if you find me for inspiration, good. If you find someone else for inspiration, that's even better. You have to find what works for you. But you have to be your own inspiration. You have to do it for yourself. You want to do it for to improve yourself, really. It's like, for me, David Goggins is my biggest influence, but he's not my only influence. I look at other people for influence. But you don't have to use the same person as me for influence. You don't have to use me for influence. Just find something that will make you change. And you probably don't understand how hard it's gonna be, but just get in the mindset that you're going to change. No matter what. Once you get in that mindset, you're gonna figure out that way to change. And yeah, it may take 5 or 10 years out of high school, but you can do it.